Hello family and friends! Today we'll be making hot chocolate bombs.
Here's what we need. A semi-sphere mold, sprinkles, mini marshmallows, chocolate melts, hot chocolate mix, a brush, and it's nice to have a cooking thermometer. First we're going to temper our chocolate. Tempering our chocolate just means that we're controlling the heat to make sure it's as strong as possible and has that nice glossy finish. For specifics like precise temperatures, we'll leave it in the description of this video, but basically the process looks like this. We melt the chocolate, then we let it cool a little bit, then we melt it again. After all that, in order to test if the chocolate is in good temper, we're going to brush a thin layer of chocolate onto parchment paper. Once it's dry and looking smooth, we know it's in good temper. So the instructions say that you should pay extra attention to the edges. Like these edges, because that's where it has the most potential to break. I think you're doing a better job than me. My paintbrush is a little too small, so I'm just making tiny little strokes everywhere.
Don't blame the brushes.
Can I use your brush? Oh yeah, this is so much better. If you're done, you can pop it into the fridge to cool for about 5 minutes.
Yeah, let's go.
Look at Felix's chocolate, it looks so good.
What should we do?
Yeah, you can do this.
Apply some pressure on the edge, but not too much.
Hey, it's not bad.
Oh.
Not bad.
They look like bugs.
I'm just gonna clean out the mold and then we're going to, excuse me. And then we're going to try to use up the rest of the chocolate and create more semi-sphere molds.
Yay!
Yay! Our next step would be to take one of our molds, get some hot chocolate.
How much? 1 tablespoon?
Roughly a tablespoon or however much you can get in there. Put some mini marshmallows inside. Add some sprinkles. So here's what we have so far.
We are painting some melted chocolate onto the edges. You can use a piping bag, but we just found this easier. Put the top half on top and smooth out where they meet. Roll it around in sprinkles to cover up the sealed edges. Yay!
Yay. It kind of looks like a planet.
We melted white chocolate for decorative drizzle. They're not perfect, but these are our hot chocolate bombs.
Not bad for a first try.
In terms of sweetness, it's spot on. Chocolate flavor is not very strong. Maybe we probably can add more chocolate. Like the chocolate ball should be a little bit thicker. Or maybe we can put 2 chocolate balls in there.
Oh yeah, I'm pleasantly surprised. I thought that the milk to chocolate ratio would be off so that there wouldn't be enough flavor. It would be watered down, but it's pretty good. Thanks for watching. Hope you try this out and do a better job than we did.
We're pretty messy.
Yeah, we were pretty messy. Happy holidays. Bye.
Happy holiday. Bye. So what should go in there?
Pretty much anything you want. Like what if you really like peppermint in your hot chocolate? You could put it in there too.
What about a piece of apple?
I don't think apple and hot chocolate.
You will want a grape in there, Olivia.
A grape?
Blueberry? Mango?
No, I don't think fruit and hot, do they go together?